Microcontrollers are useful for a great many things. One very practical application of microelectronics is to bridge together the real world and the digital world.
For this project, we are going to show how you can control this remote control car with this iPhone.
The first thing we did was to take apart the remote control, and this is what we saw. This is a pretty simple car because it doesn't allow for speed control, just forward or reverse for each of the two motors. From this picture, you can see that the left and right joysticks both just press on these metal tabs and connect them down to the wires underneath. With a multimeter, we quickly found that the metal tabs were connected to ground, and the wires underneath corresponded to forward and reverse directions. So, to hijack that behavior, we soldered long wires onto those four nodes. Using a transistor driven by the microcontroller, we can electronically override the joysticks by connecting the right ones to ground when we want a particular motor to go forward or backward. So we just need these four wires going to four transistors on the NerdKit's breadboard. The microcontroller turns on the right transistor when it wants a certain behavior. We also tapped into the battery connectors to power the NerdKit.
Here's an overview of how our system works. The iPhone talks over wireless to the computer. The computer sends information to the NerdKit, and the NerdKit controls the remote control that controls the car. So, let's go over what we did. The iPhone is running a very simple web script to figure out where you're touching on the screen. It's using the iPhone web API that has JavaScript support for advanced touch events like untouched start and untouched move. This web script is running on a web server on the same computer that is hooked up to the NerdKit.
As you can see from the relative simplicity of the code, the iPhone JavaScript API is fairly easy to use. Here, we just define functions to keep track of where your finger is on the screen. Every time it has a new value, it sends the XY coordinates over your finger using an asynchronous JavaScript call to another page.
Now that we have the coordinates of your finger on the iPhone, we need to get that information over to the NerdKit. We have already shown how we can do this with a Python script that writes information over the serial port to the NerdKit. But how can a web script give information to a running Python script? Well, to do this, we use something called a named pipe. Pipes are what we use in programming for different processes to talk to each other. PHP treats the named pipe just like a file, so you just open a file and write information to it. On the other side, the Python script opens the file and just reads the information from it and writes it over the serial port into the NerdKit. With the NerdKit hooked up and ready to turn the controller on or off, we just need to read in the value from the serial port and figure out a way to run the motor at that speed. To do this, we use a technique called pulse width modulation, or PWM. Basically, we pulse the pin on the NerdKit on and off very quickly, and what we do is control the width of each pulse. When we want the car to go quicker, we make the pulses wider, keeping the motor on for a bigger portion of the time. When we want the car to go slower, we make the pulses smaller, keeping the motor on for a smaller portion of the time, and therefore making the car go slower. Apart from controlling the car from the phone, this project also improves the car. Because we are using PWM to drive the motors, we have some sort of velocity control that we did not have before. In this video, we showed how you can use different technologies along with our NerdKit to perform a fairly complicated set of tasks. This is just one example of cool things you can do with your NerdKit. For more videos like this one, or more information about our kits, please visit us at www.nerdkits.com.